folks, Will from MinIO here with another how-to. Today we're going to be uploading objects to MinIO using a pre-signed URL. And we're going to be doing all this with our .NET platform. We're going to be using .NET version 6, and we're going to be uploading to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can upload any data they want just to work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be doing all of this out of Visual Studio 2022 for Mac. In this video, we're going to be looking at the pre-signed put object async method and its associated args object, which is used to actually set up how you're going to create this URL. Now, the important thing about the URL is that the link that you generate will expire. It doesn't require any kind of credentials to use, but it will expire. So it is a time-bound URL. Let's take a look at our code. So here we've got our .NET program. It's got a very simple main method. The main method simply calls out to play.min.io to create a connection that we can use. And it also handles all of our exceptions so that we can just focus on the code we want to focus on here. Once it's handled all of that, it actually just calls this simple run method, which returns a task. And what we're going to be doing here is generating this pre-signed put object URL. So we're going to be uploading to our bucket, .NET demo bucket. We're going to create a new object called new.text. And notice that you need to define these two things before you actually create the put object arg. So what I'm going to be handing off to an end user is a URL that defines which object they're going to be uploading to. That means that you may not want to share this with more than one user, otherwise folks are going to be uploading over top of each other. Now, if you have versioning turned on in your bucket, you can get around that a little bit. And what we're going to be calling here is the pre-signed put object async method, which takes a pre-signed put object args object. And that object, as you can see here, takes a bucket name and an object name, and then also an expiry time. The expiry time is always expressed in seconds. So I've got 60 seconds in a minute. I've got 60 minutes in an hour and 24 hours in a day. So this is actually going to be a 1 day long useful URL. After a day, it will expire. You will no longer be able to use it. Again, the URL doesn't require any credentials to use. Anybody who has access to the URL will be able to upload to this object. So let me show you why we're going to need this. I'm going to do a very simple curl command here. Curl, and when we're doing a put, I simply give it this HTTPS play.min.io, and we're going to upload to our .NET demo bucket, and we're going to upload a new file called new.text. And we're going to give it some data. And in this case, the data is just going to be a little string. I'm going to hand it new object data. And that's it. Now, when I run this, though, what I get is access denied. And the reason why I get access denied is that this bucket is set up as private. Now, I could share out credentials, or I could make the bucket public. Both of those have other security implications that we're not going to get into here. What I really want to do is I want to just create this URL that's going to allow somebody to upload some data, and I'm going to time limit that. So I'm actually going to time limit this down to about 60 seconds. So we'll go ahead and save that. Now I'm going to call .NET run, and that's going to generate a URL, but I'm going to put the URL into a file called url.txt because it's a very long URL and I want to be able to use that URL again when I call curl. So .NET run output to a URL text. I'll show you what the URL is with the cat URL text. And there it is. So it has the same URL that you saw in my curl command, going to play.min.io, the .NET demo bucket, the new.text, but it's got all this other information that identifies it as a pre-signed URL that can be used to put an object. Let me show you how that would work. So I'm going to call curl again with my X put. I'm going to do a little clever shell work here and call cat URL.txt in a little backtick. That's actually going to call that cat method that I just did and give me the URL so I don't have to retype the whole thing. And then I'm going to do a dash D new object data. Done. And if I go ahead and run this, I get nothing back. Let me show you this though. I'm going to do a MC ls on play, and we're going to take a look at the .NET demo bucket, and you will see not only do I have my hello world, my image png, which you may have seen in other how-to videos, but I also have this new.txt, all 16 bytes of it. So when I redo this command, now that my time is up, if I try to send up this new object with some changed data so that I can have a new object up there, but the same command all over again. So here we are, new object with additional data. And when I run this, what do we get? The request has expired. I can no longer use that URL. But if I want to do it again, I can always just do a .NET run URL text. That will give me a fresh URL that I can do. And then if I upload this with the additional data, now it works again. And if I call that MC command, let me go back in time to my MC command, we will see that we have a different length, 37 bytes instead of 16 bytes. So you can see that this is actually working. It is actually uploading this object to new.txt, and the URL is indeed time limited. I hope you've enjoyed this little demo on generating pre-signed put URLs to upload to MinIO. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can connect to us on any of the methods that you see here on the screen. If you'd like to communicate with us interactively, you can always look us up on minio.slack.com, or you can always leave a comment right here on this video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.